What's up, everybody? Bearded Gamer. Welcome back to part two. We had a pretty epic first part where we killed a dude, maybe kill a deer. It was intense. But yeah, let's get into it. So, let's see. I always get lost loading back into a game. So, my Witcher sense doesn't tell me where to go. Hey y'all, shibbity-dibbity. So I was reading random facts about Tomb Raider because I'm a nerd, I always research things. And originally back in 1996 when it was first started, it was a studio of just 6 people and the polygon count was like 560 just for Laura, which I think is pretty cool because, you know, the technology back then, they claimed it to be cutting edge, but you put 560 polygons into a game now, it's like the arrow count. Counter right there, that's all that is. Probably even more, but just a little interesting fact that, you know, I looked up. Hell, he see me coming around the up. Fuck this sneaking shit. Bitch.
When we washed up on this rock, the rain and wind pounded us for days. We couldn't build shelter or forage for food. Christ, we couldn't even move. It was like some enormous hand was holding us down. Just as the storm was finally breaking, Father Matthias came to us. He was calm and soft-spoken. He seemed to know us, our names, where we were from. He spoke to us in our native language, and we listened. And as we listened, he told us the truth of this island. He offered us a choice, salvation or death. Some chose to defy him. And without hesitation, he killed them then and there. Father Matthias didn't seem malicious or angry, just calm and decisive. As I stood there in the sand, wet with the blood of my comrades, I knew I could never refuse him.
Because Matthias is Nick Valentine from Fallout. Just realized that. I heard his voice last playthrough and I'm like, okay, I know his voice somewhere. It's one of my favorite companions on Fallout.
I can do this.
love the camera work, how they zoom in when she's climbing up, makes it all intense.
Worse than it is.
Have you heard from any of the others?
Nothing.
Wait, what are you doing?
The wolves took my food pack. The transmitter from the lifeboat's in it. If we don't get that back, we're not getting off this bloody island.
Yeah, but you need bandages, morphine, antiseptic.
Also in the pack.
Shit.
Exactly. Come here.
Don't do this to me, you northern bastard.
Man got me out of his rain, carrying his body and shit. About to climb up and kill some wolves. Can't use the hook yet? Oh.
Must have belonged to a U.S. Marine. What do these marks represent? Friends lost or enemies killed? Either way, he needed a drink.
Getting nowhere fast, but that was actually the right way. Thank you. I would not be going to no cave in no fucking doors. Nope. As soon as I saw that, I walked the fuck out. I know I got a gun, but if they swarm me, that's it. That music made me jump. I'll admit it.
Just want the pack. That's all.
Look off with all them shadows and shit.
Got it. Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna leave this cave. Y'all gonna leave me alone. Go chew on some bones. Not mine. Back down this hill before I get mauled again. Oh. Look at that bird.
Let's get you patched up.
Is a young lady like you learn to do a thing like that?
Late shift at the Nine Bells. Well, it's got nothing on a broken bottle.
Hey, you got it. Nice work.
So I assume the plan is to take that up to the radio tower.
Well, that should give us the best shot of broadcasting a strong signal in every direction. Send out that SOS. And I'm not climbing anytime soon.
Yeah, I was afraid you were going to say that.
You can do it, Laura. After all, you're a Croft.
I don't think I'm that kind of craft.
Sure you are. You just don't know it yet.
Well, let's have my fast letter then.
Just be careful, Laura.
Give that axe a go on the rock wall over there first.
Alright, Rock, I'll boss up. I'll climb it. Else is somebody. I gotta carry his weight. But yeah, I always like how they give her weapons in like practical situations. Like you don't just, you know, find all her shit in a chest and then she just has it. No, she gets her weapons through like experiences. Like, I need this pickaxe to climb this rock, you know, like weapons and so forth. Also, not a pickaxe, climbing axe. Just gonna correct myself right there. Tomb Raider where you can stand up on the cliff and do the little handstand. There we go.
Still works, right?
Probably. You got people up there guarding it day and night. Father Matthias doesn't want anyone going near it.
You think he has a line to the outside?
Y'all gonna burn today.
What? I need help! Oh, that was smooth. Go, little chicken. Shit in this rainstorm. I don't know how she is. I mean, I get video game logic, but yeah, I'd be slipping everything. I'd probably wash down that river, honestly.
Oh,
Chris, did you find Sam?
We're still on her trail.
I'm going to try and send an SOS from an old radio tower up here. Any tips?
Hey, Lara. You're gonna need to find the communications console. It'll look like a bunch of old switchboards.
Okay. I'll let you know when I find it.
Hey, hey, wake up! Wake up! We got an intruder! Come on, Trevor!
Please! You don't do this!
Shit. I always prefer the bow in these type of games.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Not an electrical problem.
Now, Alex.
This looks like it might be an electrical problem.
You think?
Oh, hello. Hey, is this little fox, huh?
Oh, she's cute, huh? Hey, it's cute, yeah. Alicia.
Alicia.
It's my daughter.
Oh.
14 years old and smarter than you'll ever be.
Must get that from her father.
Don't give him the attention. And, yeah.
I'll take a look at this. Probably electrical. From her father. Nice one.
So I was on the walk, right? Doing a spot of midnight fishing.
Hey, Grim. Time to button down the hatches.
I'll be right with you. So I was on the walk, right? And this thing comes looming at me. Looming out of the water it was. So I give her a old Glasgow kiss, you know. Gets you out of trouble 9 times out of 10, that does. Took me a week to sleep that night off, and I've not touched a drop since. See you at dinner, fam.
All right, can we take B-roll, please? Thank you. Dr. James Whitman, filler 15, take 3, and action.
Okay, now take a firm grip, and then slice him down the belly, like this. Yeah, you got...
Good Lord, cut! 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 Cut.
Is he coming back?
I'll go get him.
World-renowned archaeologist. I discovered...
The world-renowned archaeologist. Dr. James Whitman. It's just a fish. It's fine.
It's just a
fish. You're
gonna
be fine.
This damned reality TV business. I'm meant to be bringing culture to the people, Sam, not dinner. No offense, Jonah.
The audience demands content, Dr. Whitman. You know that. So until we find the Lost Kingdom, we need footage like this. Come on, let's just take it from the top, okay? We're gonna make you look like Gordon Ramsay in editing. Dr. James Whitman, filler 15, take 4, action.
Okay, now take a firm grip, and then slice him down the belly, like that.
I've studied them so much, I can see charts on the back of my eyelids. But if I'm not right about Yamatai being in the Dragon's Triangle...
I remember when you found that in one of your father's digs. You ran up and showed it to me dressed in your penguin pajamas.
I was 5 years old. It was my first find.
Yeah. You've got great instincts, girl. You just have to trust them.
That's what my father used to say.
Now, there was a man that ran on instinct. For better or worse. He would have been so proud of you, Lara.
We're getting closer to the storm.
Now, Whatever's coming, we'll get through it, eh?
Okay, Lara. Pull yourself together. They're counting on you.
Alright, guys. We're gonna stop it there. It's a pretty good spot. Drop a like, you know, comment down below. Greatly appreciate it. Till next time, guys.